What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're talking about units in Revit. So this may seem as a topic that's perhaps a little bit simple and straightforward, but actually it can get really, really complicated when we're talking about units in Revit, because you can set up units in multiple different places and they appear in multiple different ways. So it can get a little bit confusing, and sometimes it might feel like even though you're changing a setting, nothing's changing inside of your project. So in today's video, my goal with this video is to kind of completely cover pretty much everything that there is to know about units in Revit, and then you'll know how to troubleshoot and solve any unit related problems that you might have, or perhaps create some unit solutions. Now, before we jump into that video, I would like to encourage you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit courses. I have over 130 hours of content, and I'm adding more each month. There I cover multiple different topics in depth, slowly, step by step. I cover topics for beginners, intermediate level users, as well as advanced level users. So check it out if you're interested. And also there you can find some of my customized Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families, as well as a plugin. So make sure to check that out. Also, before we start, make sure to like this video. It helps me out a lot. It helps promote the video even more. And also make sure to subscribe. Not only will you not miss any of my future videos, but also you will make the alpaca happy as an added bonus. Okay, now without any further ado, let's jump straight into, well, not Revit at the moment. So here I just have this image that I want to use as a demonstration of what we're doing today. So when it comes to units inside of Revit, you can actually customize them at several different places. So one of those is the templates. So we're going to be talking about how units are treated by templates, and why is it crucial to use the correct template in regard to your project units. Then we'll talk about the project units themselves. So you can actually customize project units, and we'll talk about which parts or which elements does that actually affect inside of your project. Then we will talk about families and how project units actually affect families, and how to customize your families if they are in one type of a project unit into a different type of a project unit. And then finally, we will talk about project units and dimensions. You can actually have different project units for your dimensions than the ones that you're using for your projects. For example, let's say on my case, I live in Europe and I know how to work with metric units. And let's say I'm designing a house in the US. Well, for that project, I will have to kind of have the project documentation in feet and inches, but I want to use meters and centimeters to design it. So I can actually do that. I can design in meters and have my dimensions directly display in feet and inches, which is really cool. So I'll show you how to set that up. And now we're finally inside of Revit. So let's talk about templates first. As I said, using the correct template is crucial when it comes to using the proper units. So if I go here to models and then go to new, what you'll see that we get this new project dialog, and here we have to specify the correct template file that we want to use. And as I said, I prefer using metric units, and you'll see that all of my templates here have metric units. Now, what that means is if I open up one of these templates, and let's open up one of my custom templates. As I said, I have my custom templates on my website, and if you want to check these out, I'll include the link in the cards above. Now, anyways, let's say I want to open up the architecture design template. So I'm just going to specify that one here, click OK, and that's going to open up Revit at that particular using that particular template. And now if I go here and if I start placing some walls, there we go, you'll see that here the units that are used are centimeters. Now if I hit the escape key a few times, and if I go to for windows, for example, you'll see that most of the windows have metric units. Well, all of them have metric units. If I go to doors, doors also have metric units. So by default, this template has been set up in such a way where we have metric units, and everything is going to be metric out of the box. Now, let's say you're using imperial units. Well, you don't want to use this template then. And just keep in mind that on my website, if you get my templates, both of them are available in both metric and imperial units. Okay, now let's go to models. Let's go here to new, and let's say you want to use imperial units. Well, what if you don't have an option for an imperial template? What do you do then? Well, you can go here to browse and then go to imperial library, for example, or go back. Let's go back a couple of steps, go to templates, and then search for the template there, either imperial or metric. Now, this is all fine and well, but you don't always want to go here to browse. It does make sense to have them as part of this list. Well, you can actually customize that by going here to the home button, going to file, go to options, then go here to file locations, and here you will see a list of those templates that are available. So if I just click the little add value button, I can go here and let's go back a few steps. Let's go to templates. Let's say we want imperial templates, and let's say we want to use the residential default template. Well, I can specify it here, click open. And then, as you can see, we'll have another template here that's just going to appear. We can even push it up if we want. So I can actually push it all the way to the top, click OK. And now if I go to file, go back here, go to new, now you will see that the first template that appears, it's the second one. I didn't push it all the way to the top. But anyways, it's this residential default template. And now if I click OK, it's going to open up a new project with that imperial template. And what that means is if I go here to walls, you will see that all of the wall types are in inches. If I start placing those walls, you will see that the temporary units that appear here are in feet and inches. So that's how this is going to work. So that's basically how templates work, and that's why it's crucial to use the correct templates. You'll also see it for the doors, they're all in inches, and the same thing goes with windows and the rest of the families that we have. Okay, so now we have covered how to specify units in terms of templates and why it's crucial to use the correct template. Now let's talk about changing the project units. So as I said, you can have a template that's imperial, but you can change the project units to metric, and let's see how that works. So for your project units, they can be changed at any point here on the Manage tab. Go to Project Units, and as you can see here, we have the Project Units dialog where you can make changes to your units. Now here you have all of the units that you can change. So that's length, area, volume, angle, slope, currency, mass, density, time, and speed. And then here we have all of the formats. So if I want to change the length, I would just click here on the format of length, and it's going to open up the format, and then here I can change this to meters. I can even add the rounding. Let's say I want to go up to 2 decimal places. I can even add a symbol, so I can add meters here at the end. Then if I click OK, as you can see, that unit has changed. Now keep in mind, the rest of these are imperial, so if you want to actually change this to metric, you would have to go and change each one independently. I don't want to do that. I can leave it as is, and I'm just going to click OK. Now, if I select this wall, as you can see here, we have 3.5052 meters. So this is now in meters. However, if I select any of these walls here in the properties, you will see that this is still a 6-inch wall. So it's still displaying this as a 6-inch wall, even though I have changed my units to metric. So why does that happen? Well, the thing is that this wall, 6 or 8-inch wall, doesn't matter which one, this isn't really the units of the wall. This is just the name of the wall, which uses 8 inches as part of the name, displaying the thickness of the wall using the imperial units. So this is just the name. The name is generic dash 8 inches. It's not really reporting the width of the wall. And you can see that if I go here into edit type, if I go into edit structure here, you'll see that it's actually in meters. So we have changed units, and if we want to change the thickness, we can change the thickness here. Click OK. Hit apply, you'll see that this wall is now way thicker, but still the name stays generic 8-inch. So this isn't really the units of the wall, this is just the name of the wall. And if you want to change that, you would have to go here to rename and then change it to whatever you want. You can change it to BA for Balkan Architect, whatever. you can change that name. So if you want to switch your families, or your, in this case, whole families into metric units, you would have to go individually one by one and make the change of the name if you want that name to display the correct units that you want to use. So that's just something to keep in mind. Changing the units here on the project units dialog will change the units that you're working here and your working units. It will also change for your families if you go into edit type and edit structure. Here, the thickness is also in meters, but if you want to change the actual units in the name, like the generic 4-inch, 6-inch, and so on, you would have to go in and rename that. So that's just something to keep in mind, just how Revit looks at units, because sometimes it can be confusing. You can change the units here, and then you go to window, and the window is still in inches. Well, the window, if you go into edit type, here you'll see everything is in meters apart from the name. So you would have to change the name for this as well. So that's why it's good to start off with a correct template, because you don't want to have to change all of the names here. Okay, now while we're still in the project environment, let's quickly talk about units and dimensions. So if I were to dimension this, as I've shown you, the temporary dimensions, those are these blue lines, they are in meters. And also, if I were to add a dimension here, like so, this is also going to be in meters. Even though if I select this dimension, you can see that the dimension style name is still using imperial units. The metric units are used here because this dimension is basically just reporting our in our project units, which we've set up here on the Manage tab under Project Units. Now, you can actually change that. As I said, the scenario where I would like to use metric units to design a house, but I would still like the dimensions to report in imperial units for the imperial market. So how do you change that? Well, you can actually change that by selecting the dimension itself, going here to properties, going into edit type, that's going to open up the type properties, and then you can go down all the way to text. And then here we have the units format for this dimension. So if I click on that, it's going to report format, and here you'll see this little checkbox saying use project settings. So the project settings, as we've seen there on the project units dialog, the project settings are in meters, and as you can see here, it's displaying meters, two decimal places, meter unit symbol. Now, if I uncheck this, I can actually change that. So I can use feet and fractional inches, rounding to the nearest half inch, and so on. And now if I click OK, and then apply the change, click OK again. Now this will still display in inches or feet and fractional inches. However, if I select this to move it, you'll see that here I get a temporary dimension that's actually in meters. So I can still work in meters, but the dimensions will display in feet and inches, which is a really good way to kind of have one thing as a display and another thing as kind of what you're working with. And now let's just quickly talk about families and units in regards to families. So here, if I go to windows, you'll see here I have this window, folding single side. We have multiple dimensions, and you'll see that the dimensions are actually in inches. So let's actually place one of these windows here on our wall. Now, if you want to get this window, you can actually find it on my website. It's part of a pack, so I'm just going to link that up in the cards above, so check it out if you're interested. Anyways, if I select this family, you will see that it only has here inches as available units. If I go into edit type, you'll see that here, if we want to make some changes, we can make those changes, but they are going to be basically in meters because we have now changed the project units to meters. Now, if you have an imperial family like this one, or family using imperial units like this one, and you want to convert it for many future projects into a metric family, what you would have to do is go here into edit family, so open up that family as a phase, as a separate project or as a family. Click OK. Let's open that up. Here we go. So this is that window family. So what you would have to do here is go here to family types. So this is basically where you can see all of the family types for this family. And then you would have to rename them. So for example, for this one, I would have to rename it. And then I would have to say, I don't know, something like for width, I want to go with, I don't know, 70 centimeters. And then for height, I want to go with 130 centimeters. Click OK. And then I would have to change those units here. Now you can see here, the units are still in inches. Well, because we have to first change, let's click OK. Okay, so first we have to go to the Modify tab, to the Manage tab, and then change the project units here to centimeters, because that's what they want to use. Okay, and then I would go back here to family types, and now I can change this in centimeters, and then I can say, okay, this is 70 centimeters by 130 centimeters, and that's going to give me that window when I apply that change. So this is the window that we have. Obviously, this is way too small for width for this type of a window, so let's try something a little bit bigger. So let's try 120, hit apply. That should work a little bit better. There we go, it does. And then I can just rename this type here, let's say 120. Okay, so I would have to go kind of slowly, step by step, and I would have to change each one of these individually, so it can take a while to change them, but the whole point is you can customize it to kind of the standard dimensions that you're using in your area, and then also when you save that, all of the types will be saved, so when you load that family into your project, here instead of having this displayed in inches, it will be displayed in centimeters or whichever other unit you decide to use. So there we go. I think I have covered pretty much kind of all sides and all approaches in terms of units. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and I hope you have learned something new. And I will be back in a couple of days with a new Balkan Architect tutorial. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.